Imagine Mount Everest, the tallest mountain on Earth, placed at the deepest point in the ocean. Its peak wouldn't even reach the surface. It would still be buried under a mile of water. In fact, if you polished Earth into a perfect sphere, all the water that would be displaced would create a global ocean over a mile deep. Yet despite covering 91% of our planet, we've mapped just 20% of the ocean floor. Google Maps makes it look like we've charted it all, but most of our ocean maps are fuzzy, 1.5 kilometers of error, compared to 30 centimeters for land. So how was James Cameron able to venture into a world more alien than Mars? Today, I'll show you the four depths of this mysterious world, from the sunlit surface to the crushing abyss. This is the sunlit zone, where light penetrates and life flourishes. Coral reefs here are like bustling underwater cities, home to millions of fish, turtles, and crustaceans. In fact, the Great Barrier Reef is so vast it can be seen from space, stretching over 2,300 kilometers. But beneath this beauty lies history. Scattered across the ocean floor are silent reminders of the past, like the SS Thistlegorm, a World War II shipwreck resting at just 30 meters. But venture just a little deeper and the light begins to fade. As we descend past 40 meters, the ocean shifts, sunlight weakens, and shadows grow. This is the Twilight Zone, home to the giants of the sea. The blue whale, the largest creature on Earth, dives to these depths to gorge on massive swarms of krill. And just a little deeper, at 93 meters, lies the RMS Lusitania, a tragic relic of naval warfare now swallowed by the sea. Surprisingly, this part of the ocean is also alive with movement. At around 100 to 200 meters, countless tiny creatures rise from the depths in the largest daily migration on Earth. This phenomenon, known as the deep scattering layer, confounded early sonar operators who thought they were seeing a false ocean floor. Now we plunge into true darkness, past 500 meters where the sunlight disappears completely. This is the midnight zone, where only the most extraordinary creatures can survive. This is also the depth in which the average nuclear submarine dives to. And of course, the anglerfish, with its eerie bioluminescent lure. It attracts prey in the black abyss. Its glowing light is just one of many adaptions in a world where food is scarce, energy is preserved, and danger is everywhere. Even here, history lingers. At 3,800 meters rests the RMS Titanic, frozen in time. The pressure here is 380 times that of the surface, enough to crush a human instantly. Yet below in the icy depths, the wreck remains. Deeper still, at around 2,500 meters, we find something even stranger. Hydrothermal vents spewing boiling water laced with minerals. Instead of relying on sunlight, entire ecosystems thrive here, powered by chemical energy from the Earth's crust. This discovery, made in 1977, changed everything we knew about life on Earth. At 4,000 meters, we reach the abyssal plain, a vast, desolate expanse covering more than half of the Earth's surface. Here, the wreck of the USS Johnston, a World War II destroyer, lies. Deeper still, at 8,000 meters, the pressure reaches unimaginable levels, 800 times that of the surface. The only creatures that survive here, like the Mariana snailfish, are uniquely adapted to this crushing world, thriving when nothing else can. And then at nearly 11 kilometers below the surface, we arrive at the Challenger Deep, the deepest known point in the ocean. To gauge the true depth of this place, here you can see 13 Burj Khalifas stacked on top of each other. To truly understand the scale, let's shrink the submarine down to a more accurate size, and then zoom out. It truly is incredible just how far down that really is. But this isn't it. In 2012, filmmaker James Cameron made a solo descent here, describing it as visiting another planet. The pressure at this depth is over 1,000 times that of the surface, enough to crush steel like paper. Yet, even in this eternal darkness, life endures. Microorganisms flourish around hydrothermal vents, drawing energy from the Earth itself. This is our planet's final frontier, a place of crushing depths and endless mystery. Less than 20% of this ocean floor has actually been explored. The unknown isn't in the stars above, it's in the darkness below.